Hi, and welcome to this edition of Limelight. I'm your host, Specialist Jeremy Todd. The importance of Fort Polk and the Joint Readiness Training Center is no secret. Training for deployment is a big part of why we are here. Along with this comes the visitation of some very important people. Recently, we had a visit from the Secretary of Defense, Robert Gates.
The Joint Readiness Training Center is no stranger to high-ranking military members. Secretary of Defense Robert M. Gates visited Fort Polk and observed a scenario where soldiers move through a village and are bombarded by enemy fire and screaming civilians. Although he had a busy schedule, Secretary Gates set aside time to talk to instructors of JRTC, as well as soldiers going through the rotation.
But Secretary Gates was not the only VIP that visited our post recently. Army Chief of Staff General George Casey was met at the Alexandria International Airport and flown directly to Northport to observe our soldiers' training. There, General Casey was given a first-hand look at how role players and the JRTC staff provide realistic combat training. He then stopped by the dining facility to speak with the members of the 101st Airborne Division from Fort Campbell, Kentucky. He let them know how important their training is and even fielded a few comments on how it's matching up with their real-world mission. Being physically fit is a well-known fact about being in the Army. I got up at the crack of dawn to catch a brigade run.
Driving to work on a weekday can be a little slow during the early morning hours. On the first Friday in May, more than 2,500 4th Brigade 10th Mountain soldiers commandeered the roads on Fort Polk for a brigade run. The massive group of runners, wearing their respective battalion t-shirts, parted the dense fog and controlled the roads for over an hour. The commander of Fort Polk and JRTC, Brigadier General Daniel Bolger, along with the command group of 4th Brigade 10th Mountain, led the five battalions in one squadron on the brigade run. Pounding the Fort Polk roads were 10th Mountain soldiers from 3rd Squadron 89th Cavalry Regiment, 5th Battalion 25th Field Artillery, 2nd Battalion, 4th Infantry Regiment, 94th Brigade Support Battalion, 2nd Battalion, 30th Infantry Regiment, and 4th Brigade Special Troops Battalion, as well as attachments from the Air Force. Nearly 4 miles later, 4th Brigade soldiers crested the hill and headed back. As each battalion of the runners circled around, they were congratulated by their fellow soldiers, and even a few families came to show their support.
AFIS continues with the overall improvements of their facilities. Last year, they opened a 24-hour shopette and completely remodeled shopette number 2. This year, they remodeled, repaved, and added diesel fuel to their inventory at shopette number 3. Recently, the Huddle House had its grand opening. The Huddle House is the newest standalone restaurant and is the first restaurant on post to offer dining 24 hours a day. And now AFIS has held their grand opening for the new mini mall. The newest in the AFIS line replaces the older service station, yet the new mini mall has a shopette, service department, a 4-chair barber shop, and the newest sandwich shop on post. The ribbon was cut and the doors were opened for business. Free sandwiches and snacks were given while people took tours and checked out the new facilities. Community relations is an ongoing effort to reinforce our good standings with our neighbors. I went along with a handful of soldiers to Rose Pine Elementary School for a special presentation.
The Army values play a vital role in every soldier's life. 7 Fort Polk soldiers had the opportunity of speaking with 5th and 6th graders in the 4-H Club of Rose Pines Elementary School on April 20th. Each soldier prepared and delivered a lesson on how they apply the Army values on a daily basis. The Fort Polk soldiers from 4th Brigade's 10th Mountain Division performed above and beyond what was expected, according to Teresa Hess, Community Relations Director for Fort Polk. The 4-H students had the opportunity to ask questions as well as participate in the singing of the Army song. At the end of the presentation, the soldiers handed out gifts for the Rose Pine Elementary students, and on a surprise note, the 4-H Club asked if they could donate $100 to the Army Emergency Relief Fund.
We here at Limelight continuously try to highlight soldiers that are stationed here at Fort Polk. I'm proud to bring you the first in what we hope will be many future profiles of our soldiers. Here now is Soldier Story.
Specialist Daniel D. Lord, and this is my story. I grew up in Oxnard, California. That's located in Southern California, about like an hour away from Los Angeles. Oxnard's it's a decent sized town, about like 300,000 people there. We're known for our agriculture. We're about like 5-10 minutes away, drive from the beach, and the weather's great. It's like, I can wake up in the morning expecting it to be a nice sunny day, good weather. I like to skateboard with my friends. We like to skate around the neighborhood a little bit, go to the skate park once in a while. So sometimes me and my friends will just play guitar, jam out to a couple of songs. Well, there was many circumstances which led me to joining the Army. Just my dad was in the military once. When 9/11 happened, that was a really big part in me joining. And just after high school, I just wanted to do something in my life, and I just wanted to try something different. I wanted to become an MP just because in civilian life, I wanted to become a police officer. Like, I talked with police officers, seeing what I had to do to actually become one. And when I figured out that the military had a police corps, that it'd be perfect for me just because I can be in the military, do something that I wanted to do, and become a police officer, which was a goal that I had in life. I feel confident in my unit just because the leaders are good, they care for you, the soldiers are great, they're motivated, they're fit, they care about each other. They do know what they're doing. I'm Specialist Daniel D. Lord.
If you are a supervisor of a soldier you would like profiled on Soldier Story, email Kimberly Reichling, our Command Information Officer at the Public Affairs Office. That brings to a close this edition of Limelight. If you have a story idea or would like to volunteer to help with Limelight, please email Ms. Reichling. I'm Specialist Jeremy Todd. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the Limelight.